Just talking about Indian English for a moment, it's a fascinating, very large English. And shortly, I think India and China are going to be the largest English-speaking countries in the world. There's more than 300 million people learning English in China anyway. And in Indian English, my favourite example is preponing. Because in our English, you can postpone something, which means you make it later.
Yes.
And in Indian English, you can prepone something.
What does that involve?
It's happening earlier rather than later.
That's the word for bringing it forward.
Mm. It's very logical. It's using bits of English, which are already there, in a way which is fully consistent with the rules of English.
Well, Indians have postpositions instead of prepositions.
They do.
Because of the structure. So maybe they're used to inverting some of these things.
Maybe so. But there are others, you know. So-and-so was busy with academics for years. And
yes.
That means just academic pursuits.
That's right.
Not people. Right? And so Indian English often uses English words, but in a slightly shifted way. And you need to know your way around in order not to get mixed up. The one I think is really nice is revert. And please revert, meaning get back to me,
yes.
Report back, okay? Whereas revert, in my English, means going back to a previous habit, possibly a bad one. You know, he reverted to a state of alcoholism.
Yes. Yeah. And what's your good name? Indians ask, what's your good name?
Oh.
What's your first name?
Oh, right. Thank you. I didn't know that one.